Well, what a performance by Leeds. Oh. They really played well, although you have to say Villa were, I thought, a bit below par, didn't really
a bit under par. Villa, they've been playing reasonably well. Pitch looked a bit dodgy. Yes, we all know there's problems there, but you play on what you've got. And Leeds United were superb. Well, I thought that was a wonderful performance.
I thought little Strachan was pulling his strings, and obviously in midfield, the murdered Villa, and Big Ron's going out and bought Paul Parker in midweek from Nottingham Forest.
So. Yeah, they bought Parker. I said earlier on that they needed Lady Penelope and the rest of the Thunderbirds as well, and they might get a chance then.
Everyone at Chatsworth this season gets one of those, and you're the first.
Jim, so a great privilege.
You've always wanted one of those, haven't you?
Yes, from now on, every time I see a mug, I'll think of Saint and Greavesy.
All right, a couple of right old mugs here. Right.
It's a fair point, Jim, but 2 years ago, remember when Spurs were building their stand, they never got it finished, missed the first day of the season. Now, the league deducted two points. Spurs appealed, and then it finally went to a £15,000 fine. So a precedent has been set, so I don't think anything will happen.
I think what should have happened, Ian, is at the back end of last season, the league should have said, look, who's not ready for the beginning of this season, you forfeit your game. That would have solved the problem, because clubs would have known where they stand. But as usual, and Howard's right, we never quite get it right from an administrative point of view.
From the team building point of view, they've spent a lot of money again, as they did last year. They were a good side last year. They've added to it. Can they win the title at 12-1 in the betting?
Well, would you have a go at that? I'd have a punt at 12-1, would you, to be honest?
No, I think, you know, they have bought some players, but I don't think they don't look to me like a championship team. I think they'll be hard to beat as well last year, but I don't think they'll win it.
I think they'll be hard to beat. One always says that of Leeds United, particularly loads of us who've been up there enough. And that's true, but I do actually feel that they probably haven't quite got it right to actually win the league championship. When you look at it, it doesn't look right, does it?
No, I think we both agree on that one. Well, that's it for part one.
Although it's a penalty, and we know that, I don't think there was any intent behind that other than to get the ball. And he's got to feel unlucky that he actually walked for that, because it was a good tackle, but it caught the man and not the ball. Penalty, no argument. But they're not entitled to get sent off.
I mean, it's got the makings, I think, of a very exciting game.
One would hope so, sir.
Yeah. Well, 5 goals in the last game, let's hope we get 5 in this one, James. Mm-hmm. Right. Well, if the Leeds and Everton fans get a couple of games like that next week, Jim, they'll be very happy.
And hell.
Super football.
On the week commencing the 6th of January.
OK, let's recap on the draw. There we have Spurs against Norwich City. Swindon or Crystal Palace will play Nottingham Forest or Southampton. Peterborough will play Middlesbrough. And Leeds United will play Manchester United.
I'll tell you
That's last year's semi-final, Jim.
It is last year's semi-final. I'll tell you what, Donald. Are you thinking of opening a store in England?
Well, I think we're going to maybe go over there and watch a couple of these games.
Take my advice. You can open one in Leeds, but don't go to Manchester.
I'll be there.
But will he be there? I mean, will he be fit enough? That's the thing.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's difficult at the moment. I'm sure he doesn't know.
I hope he plays.
Yes.
Robson not playing for United, of course, was a blow for them.
Yeah.
But funny thing about that, you know, I'd said at the beginning of the season that if Robson's fit, United could win the league. I fancy them to win it if Robson was fit. Now, he's played most of this season, but lately he's missed a couple of games, but they've carried on, Jim, winning.
Yeah, they're doing well.
So it looks to me as if they're getting over that.
They've got a good squad now. It's amazing how these games have come out of the act. They've got to play each other 3 times in, 10, 12 days, 11 days. And, you know, they're going to be sick of the sight of each other, and the chances are that one's going to go to a replay as well. With the Rumbelows and the Cup as well. So it's one of those horrendous situations that no players look forward to on either side, really.
Well, they could burn themselves out in it, and if somebody else was close enough to take advantage, it would have been fine, but there's nobody there.
But they're going to be sick of the sight of each other, there's no doubt about that.
But I'm looking forward to that one tomorrow. But we'll take a break there.
I mean, Whitey was fabulous, and John here, he could nick in and score a few goals as well. And we all know he could be a little bit nasty in the middle of the field when he wanted to be, which is also nice when you've got a great player who can put a bit about as well. Right. Lovely, great player, John Jones. Well,